said for her guilty pleasure, she would like to ride around on her Arabian horse while eating Swiss chocolate and not worrying about her clothes shrinking. Very specific and very sexy. So, without further ado, please, a large round of applause for Michelle Elise.
Hello. I have transient amnesia. This means my brain lives in parallel universes. I don't know where I'm at, but yet I must logically think through the day. This, as a scientist, fascinates me. I see myself completely evaporating through into dust. I know when I enter amnesia, and yet I do not know anything about myself. I become a blank slate. True story. One Saturday morning, I woke up early. I took my Sadie out. We're not moving. We're stuck. Well, let's do a little improv here without the F-bomb. Too bad my Arabian horse isn't here to entertain you. This is Sadie. We went out early one Saturday morning to let her do her thing. It was early, so we went back to bed. About 8:30, I woke up. I did not know where I was, and I did not know who I was. I had visions of horses in my mind. Who are these creatures? I looked to the right, and the pillow was unfussed. I thought, I live by myself. Who am I? Where do I live? I had no clue. And then suddenly, a dog jumped on the bed, and I thought, what a wonderful way to wake up. Who are you? And she flopped down beside me. And that's when I looked at her tag. It said home again. Two cats came, one with the most beautiful turquoise eyes, bled off to pearl, another with orange eyes matching his orange fur. This is my family. I don't know. Then we walked out into the next room. It was totally unfamiliar. I looked for the cat food and fed them and the dog food. I saw a phone. I picked up the receiver. It had a list of names. I saw Carol. That's familiar. Let me call her. She said, hello, Michelle Elise, how are you? In a somber tone, I said, I have amnesia. Who's the dog and who are the horses? I have no clue. She told me about the horses and that he's been with me for 13 years and he saved my life. They're about 2 miles away. I must get to him. And I found the bridge, and she told me about the blue sign to look for. We got closer, and I was like, oh, yes, there they are. But first, we have to get to the parking lot. And there were 60 cars, and I didn't know which car was mine. She ran out to the car, and I flashed the lights. She was sitting. I said, smart dog. As I drove to my Arabians, I was getting excited because ahead there was a blue sign, and she was getting excited. She was recognizing it. She's smarter than I am. We pulled in, and everybody said hello, and there's my Arabian waiting for me. I threw my arms around his neck, and I felt safe. There was a profound solidification inside of me, and I spent time with him, never speaking a word, and yet he understood every motion that I made. He understood my behavior, and I thought, this is very interesting. You know what I'm thinking before I can be my own lab rat. I can study myself. 10 million people are affected with traumatic brain injuries every single year around the globe and other brain disorders. I have a new quest. Ideas flooded my brain. I can study brain spotting, bringing the subconscious to the conscious level. Why didn't I think of this before? There are so many people that could benefit if we could just help them understand. I studied neuroscience, the reaction of a reptilian brain, the organization of the frontal lobe. I studied the limbic system, the heart of the brain. It began clearly. My horse is a neuroscientist. He was teaching me neural behavior. Without words, he just responded. So this started a new quest, ideas, and the fact that I could begin to understand the emergence of a subconscious consciously and begin to relate in a different way, internal. In April and Monday, I abated two amnesia episodes with cognitive neurobehavior recognition. Thank you. There are times in our lives when we have a catastrophic event and we come up with solutions that for decades they can be built upon, and we do this for the sake of humanity. Thank you.